Welcome to this tutorial on copying your course from Blackboard Original to Blackboard Ultra. To begin, navigate to the course content page in your Ultra course. In the top right corner, select the three-dot menu next to the search option. Note that in Ultra, you'll pull items into your current course rather than pushing them from your old course as you used to do in Original. So if I'm in my current course, I go to the three-dot menu, and from the drop-down menu, I'll click Copy Items. A list of your courses will appear. If you don't see the course you're looking for right away, you can use these arrows at the top or the bottom to navigate, or you can use the search bar to find the course that you want. These are listed alphabetically, so your fall courses will probably come up first. When you search, you do need to have the exact case, numbers, and letters, and any spaces or anything put in exactly as they are. Once you find your course, you can use this checkbox to copy over the entire thing, but this is not recommended. A full course copy often brings in extra items from Original that you don't need in Ultra. Instead, I recommend selecting individual items to copy. To do that, click the arrow to the right of the name of your course, and then choose only the content that you want. As you select items, they'll appear in this list to the right. You can keep selecting items and they'll keep populating to the right. Here I've selected all of Blackboard Basics, but let's say I only want some of the folder that says Good to Know. I can use the right arrow again to just find those items that I want, select them, and have them appear on the right. If you want to go back within the copy content view before you start the copy, use the breadcrumbs at the top instead of the blue X to avoid losing your progress. So here, I'm going to go back to the full course training IDC 02. Then I'm going to decide whether I want any more of this content. Let's go ahead and look in the About Discussions folder, and we'll pick a couple of things to copy from there as well. As you can see, those are also added to my list. I can always come back later if I want to copy more items. For now, I'm going to go ahead and start copy. This takes a few moments. You can step away and get a drink of water, or just wait for it to finish patiently. Or impatiently. After the conversion, you may see a list of exceptions here at the top. These are typically minor formatting changes that can be safely ignored. I'm just going to close the report now. You should always double check your content, check any test questions and any links each semester to ensure accuracy and that things haven't changed. That goes for Blackboard Original, Blackboard Ultra, or really any other LMS you're switching your course to or copying to. Keep in mind that any announcements you had will copy in as drafts. They will not be automatically posted. If you do want to reuse any of the announcements, you'll need to also click Post so that your students can see them. Settings such as due dates, visibility status, release conditions will all carry over, so you may need to update those as well. If you want to update all of your due dates or all a lot of visibility at once, you'll want to use the batch edit option. To use that, go back to the three dots on the upper right of your course, and from the context menu, select Batch Edit. You can see everything in this course came in hidden, If I wanted to make several of these things visible, but not all of them, I can select what I want, click Edit Visibility, and then click Visible. This also takes a moment. I'm going to wait patiently or impatiently for this to finish. Once I see that items were updated successfully, I know it's complete, and I can see these items are visible. If you want to edit due dates, you can also do that in batch here. This can be a good way to start, although usually you'll need to go in and further edit them later. One thing you could do is you could change everything to be due. Let's say it's spring and January, and then further edit that later. You can move things forward a certain number of days. So you might decide to move things, everything forward 180 days, and then go in to double check things. Or you can choose to change the dates based on when the course starts. For now, I'm going to shift everything forward 180 days. I'm going to go ahead and select edit dates. I don't have anything with due dates, so that's not going to do anything right. And that's it. Now you can go in and edit your content, add content, set up your gradebook, and make sure everything looks like you want it. For additional help, reach out to the CELT team. Thanks for watching and have a great semester.